Good afternoon. Make me your instrument. That is a prayer we need to have in our life. Make me, Lord, as your instrument here in this world. Make me your instrument of peace. Make me your instrument of love. Make my heart and my soul and my all being as your dwelling place. I need to have the indwelling presence of the Holy Trinity in my life. Make me, dear Lord, as your instrument. That should be our prayer every day in our life. The Easter time, we started with the same series from the third week of Easter, third Sunday of Easter. There we have seen Simon Peter, how become an instrument in the hands of the Lord. After hearing the threefold confession of Simon Peter in Jesus Christ, Jesus was asking him, "Do you love me?" Three times the threefold confession done by Simon Peter. "Dear Lord, you know everything. I love you with my whole heart." Jesus told him, "Feed my sheep." There we have seen Jesus was making Simon Peter as an instrument of evangelization, as an instrument of proclaiming the risen Christ, as an instrument of proclaiming the good news of Jesus Christ, that Jesus is risen. Later on, we see there in the life of Saint Paul and also Barnabas, they have become the true instrument there in the hands of Jesus Christ, proclaiming the good news that Jesus is risen. The people around everywhere we can see, they were acknowledging, admitting that Jesus has risen, and Jesus is staying with them. But dear brothers and sisters, when we look into the readings of today, there we can see the heavenly Lord desires to come and dwell within us. The indwelling presence of the Holy Trinity, as well as the indwelling presence of the Holy Spirit that given by Jesus Christ. We need to have a desire to become an instrument in the hands of the Holy Spirit. That is the invitation. That is the invitation Jesus is giving each and every one of us today. Are we ready to submit ourselves there in the hands of the Holy Spirit? That is why Jesus says there in the gospel, "If you love me, you will obey my word." What is the reward? What is the assurance that we are going to receive if we are loving Jesus Christ, the God? If we are obeying the commandments of the Lord, the Father himself is coming. We will come and make your body as a dwelling place. That is assurance that the Heavenly Father is giving each and every one of us. Let us make as an instrument, place ourselves in the hands of the Holy Spirit. That is our invitation today through the gospel Jesus is putting in front of us. Loving God always implies an obedience, or in other words we can say, a submission of our will there in the will of God. Submitting ourselves there in the hands of the Lord, or making ourselves as an instrument there in the hands of the Lord, that is what it means, the loving God. We can see there in the life of Jesus Christ, he laid his own life for love, in order to love us. in order to redeem us, in order to save each and every one of us. The real infinite love that we can see there in the life of Jesus Christ. He was always obeying the commandments of the Lord. He was obeying the word of the Lord. That way God the Almighty was glorifying Jesus Christ through the ascension and the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Jesus told to the disciple, I do not call you as a servant. Rather, I am calling you as a friend. What is the importance of friendship, my dear brothers and sisters? There we can see a friendship, a true friendship is having. There is no limit there in the love. There is no boundaries there in the love. There is no condition there in the love. That is the true love Jesus Christ given to us in our life in order to save us. The unconditional love offered by Jesus Christ through his passion, suffering and death, Jesus has given us the salvation. When we are becoming the true instrument there in the hands of the Lord as an instrument of love, Jesus is offering the clear gift there in the gospel, the peace be with you. I am giving you my peace. My peace is not like the worldly peace. What is the worldly peace? That is the absence of conflict. That is the absence of maybe some problems. But the peace that Jesus Christ is offering each and every one of us is nothing but the presence of the Holy Spirit. It is not the absence. It is the presence of Holy Spirit and the indwelling presence of the Holy Trinity. That is the peace, my dear brothers and sisters, we have received in our life through our baptism. The peace of Christ and the Holy Spirit is given each and every one of us through the church. Church is the instrument through which we have received. When we have become the members of the church through our baptism and confirmation, the same Holy Spirit and the gifts and grace of God already dwelling within us. That is why Saint Paul says, you are the temple of God. The Holy Spirit dwells in you. We have to understand the real presence of the Holy Spirit, the real peace of the Holy Spirit in our life. That is what Jesus is giving us today. In the first reading of today, we have seen how the gift of the Holy Spirit, the peace worked there in the community, there in the first Christian community. There was a doctrinal dispute was going on. There we have seen the disciples were going to Jerusalem, to the church, to the apostles, to the disciples, to the work of the Holy Spirit. They offered themselves at the hands of the Holy Spirit in order to receive an answer for their problems. Inspired and guided by the Holy Spirit, they arrived into a conclusion that the grace and also the gift of the Holy Spirit is leading a person to have the faith in Jesus Christ, or maybe the salvation and redemption is a work of the Holy Spirit. See how They're in the early Christian community. They have solved a problem with the power, with the understanding of the Holy Spirit. In other words, we can say they laid themselves at the hands of the Holy Spirit. Through that, they have solved the problem there in the church. My dear brothers and sisters, we may have many of the life difficulties and problems in our life. We have to understand and realize that the same Holy Spirit and the peace of Christ is within us. The invisible presence of the risen Lord is always there. That is why Jesus says there in the gospel, your heart do not be troubled and also to be afraid. The invisible presence of Christ and the Holy Spirit within you. I am going, but the loving Father is sending you, or he is going to give you the Holy Spirit, the advocate, one who is coming and guiding you what you do here in this world. And also he will remind you what I taught you. What a wonderful, beautiful gifts, my dear brothers and sisters, we have received from Jesus Christ. The risen Christ has offered the peace and the Holy Spirit. That is the gift that we receive today, especially through the gospel reading. The peace of Christ is given to us. Let us experience that. If you want to experience the real peace of Christ, as Jesus said, we have to love our God with our heart, with our full and perfect love. We have to offer to our Lord. We have to obey the word of the Lord. Then the Almighty God is telling today through the gospel, we will come and dwell within you, the presence of the Holy Spirit. There in the public ministry, Jesus was experiencing the real presence of the Holy Spirit through the baptism. The Holy Spirit came down from heaven upon Jesus Christ. There in the transfiguration of Jesus Christ, the Holy Spirit came down and upon Jesus Christ. The beloved Father, we heard a voice there. He is my beloved Son, whom I am pleased. That is the gift, that is the peace, my dear brothers and sisters, Jesus is offering to each and every one of us today. We have to understand, we are not alone here in this world. The advocate, the comforter, the teacher, the guide, the source of peace, Holy Spirit is within us. We have to understand, we have to experience the real peace of the Holy Spirit, the gift of the Holy Spirit in our life through our prayer. The real sacrificial presence of Jesus is there in the altar. Today we are going to celebrate. We are going to experience through the church, Jesus, the peace of the Holy Spirit is present. The grace of God is always present through the sacrament, the sacramental presence. The risen Christ is, the suffered and died, the crucified Christ is present there in the Eucharist. We are going to experience, my dear brothers and sisters, provided we need to have the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the power of the Holy Spirit. When we experience the power of the Holy Spirit in our life, we can really experience the visible and invisible presence of Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit there in this Holy Eucharist. Let us offer ourselves there in the hands of the Holy Spirit as an instrument and receive the peace and joy and happiness in our life and go forth for proclaiming the same peace, the risen Christ there in the world. We have to share the same love in our life and also to the people. When you are ready to offer yourself as an instrument there in your home, there in your working place, we can share, my dear brothers and sisters, the same peace and joy and happiness, especially the gift today Jesus is giving, the peace and the Holy Spirit. Please ourselves, surrender ourselves. Let us be submissive to the will of the Holy Father and the Heavenly God, and the Trinitarian, the Holy God, the Holy Trinity, in front of the Holy Spirit, and pray to the Lord. This should be our prayer. Dear Lord, make me your instrument here in this world. May God bless you.